أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم In the name of Allah, the most gracious, most merciful I greet you, my dear viewers in our Islamic way Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh May Allah's peace, mercy and blessings be with you all As we mentioned before The glorious Qur'an describes the cosmos with the established description the heaven and the earth or the heavens and the earth. And we mentioned also that the word heaven or firmament or sky is mentioned in the glorious Quran 310 times, 120 times in the singular form, as-sama, qualified or unqualified, as-sama or sama, the firmament or firmament, and 190 times in the plural form, also qualified or unqualified, as samawat or samawat, the firmaments or firmaments. And equally enough, the earth is also mentioned in the glorious Quran 462 times, all in the singular form, except for a single case that came at the end of Surah Al-Talaq, which reads, Allahu alladhi khalaqa sab'a samawatin wa min al-ard mithlahun. Allah who has created the seven firmaments and from the earth exactly the like. And people wonder, really, are there seven earths? And why didn't the Quran spell this fact out? Is the number seven a decisive number in the glorious Quran? Or is it a way of expressing exaggeration, abundance? Actually, we came to find out that the word sama is mentioned in the glorious Quran seven times exactly. And this emphasizes the fact that the number seven is meant precisely as an exact number, seven. There is a notion about sab'a tara'ikh, seven ways, and these speak about the separation between one firmament and the other. And of course, in the narrations of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, we find him repeatedly mentioning the seven earths and seven firmaments. And as we mentioned earlier, this indicates a unique position for the earth within the seven firmaments. And the fact that the seven earths are within our earth, and our earth is simulating the central point of the seven firmaments, which are seven globes enveloping each other. We read in Surah Talaq, Allah الذي خلق سبع سماوات ومن الأرض مثلهن. Allah is who has created seven heavens and of the earth the like thereof. So there must be there seven earths. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is quoted to have said, اللهم رب السماوات السبع وما أضللن ورب الأرضين السبع وما أقللن. O Lord, the Lord of the seven firmaments and whatever they shadowed, covered, and the Lord of the seven earths, whatever they carried. And this indicates that there are seven earths within our earth and seven firmaments around our earth. And then we came to face a saying by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, which reads, من ظلم قيد شبر من الأرض طوقه من سبع أرضين. Whoever would take a hand length of this earth unduly in a form of aggression, he will be surrounded by seven equivalents from the seven different earths. And another saying, من ظلم قيد شبر من الأرض خسف به يوم القيامة إلى سبع أرضين. Whoever would snatch a hand length of this earth unduly, unjustly, without due right, he will be actually thrown down to the seventh earth on the Day of Judgment. And this is actually a warning from doing injustice to each other throughout our existence on the surface of that planet. But at the same time, it emphasizes the fact that the seven earths are actually included within our earth. Recent discoveries in the area of seismology has indicated that our earth is actually composed of seven spheres enveloping each other. We have the inner core, mainly composed of iron and nickel. Iron 90%, nickel 9%, light elements 1%. And then the outer molten core, having a similar composition, but in a semi-molten state. And then three successive layers of mantle, the lower mantle, the middle mantle, and the upper mantle. And then the subcrust and the crust. Seven distinctive layers that vary in their density, and any form of natural or artificial earthquake would delineate the boundaries between these seven earths in great precision. So from the sayings of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, we came to understand that the seven earths are all within our earth, and our earth represents the central point of the seven firmaments, and they have exactly a similar structure, seven globes enveloping each other. And this is the Quranic representation of our universe. Seven earths is within our earth. Our earth represents a tiny little dot in the axial position of the seven firmaments, which are seven globes enveloping each other. And of course, we can see that this description is more precise than any human description, even at a time of great advancement in the area of astronomy in particular, and of science and technology in general. Another argument was raised. Did the earth and the firmaments, or were the earth and the firmaments created in exactly at the same time, or one preceded the other? And this was an argument repeatedly mentioned by many astronomers as well as many scholars of the glorious Quran. We read in Surah Al-Baqarah, the second chapter in the glorious Quran, and the lengthiest chapter, verse number 29, which reads, هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَسَوَّاهُنَّ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. He, meaning Allah, all glory be to him, is who created for you, that is, on earth. When he rose over towards the heaven in a way that suits his glory and made them